objective reached. Scanning defenses.
Keep those synths away from Prime, soldier! Throw everything you have at them. Prime's mission must succeed!
The mission is proceeding as planned, Paladin. Well done.
Head inside, Paladin. You're not helping by standing out here.
Disappointed. I expected more from them.
Engage. Doesn't that remind you of all these years?
That makes me want to know how it was back then.
Initiated.
We're not alone.
The reactor. It's accessible through the Advanced Systems Division. Only, you can't reach it. The security override can only come from the Director's terminal. You'll need to access his quarters.
Didn't expect to see you again. Come to see the reactor, have you? We got it working without you. Oh, don't pretend to care now. You had your chance to help me, and cast me aside instead. It's not enough that I lay here dying. Now you plan on what? Destroying everything? Tell me then. Under what righteous pretense have you justified this atrocity? Perhaps I didn't think to count you among them. Well, none of it matters now, I suppose. You'll accomplish your task and ruin humanity's best hope for the future. The only question left then is why you're standing here. Is it regret? Or did you just come to gloat? Why would I ever consider helping you? Terminal behind me. Enter access code 9003. That will disable some of the synths. Now go. Just leave me.
Should be clear to the reactor. And I am happy to report that reinforcements have arrived.
Shame. It's ours now.
Do things around here.
Movement detected. Curious.
We've got company.
I swore I heard something.
Hostile sensor reading detected.
Hostile sensor reading detected. By order of the enemy.
Hitting me is a bad idea.
Thank you.
I think it's time to leave this place to its fate. Proctor Ingram, do you copy? Our mission is complete. I need you to transport us out of here immediately. Dr. Ingram, it's time to teleport us out.
Sorry, Elder, I would,
don't leave me here!
Authorization 1YR31.
Well, I want to go with you!
This child showed up. He claims to be the Paladin's son, sir.
Thank you for your cooperation.
Really? Do you mean it? I'm glad you are here to save me.
Got this covered, Paladin. Get to that reactor. Everything looks green. System's warmed up and ready to go if you are. You got it, Paladin. I'm going to send you and Elder Maxon directly to the detonation site. I'll make sure the kid gets some new clothes and reaches the airport safely. When that reactor goes up, this place will be nothing but a smoking crater full of rubble. Should be quite a sight. Looks like your work here is done, Paladin.
I'm ready. Let's get out of here.
Attention all personnel. Evacuation initiated. Authorization 1YR31. Please proceed to your assigned evacuation points. Thank you for your cooperation.
Dr. Ingram has assured me that we'll be outside the blast radius. Press that button, and you not only defeat our enemy, you restore order and decency to the Commonwealth. It's time, Paladin. The Institute and their synth abominations must be eradicated.
I can feel it wash over me. The heat, the force, the radiation, the fear. It's the end of the world all over again. I close my eyes. I see my life before all of this, before the bombs. Everything can change in an instant, and the future you plan for yourself shifts, whether or not you're ready. At some point, it happens to all of us. This wasn't the world I wanted, but it was the one I found myself in. The Commonwealth. My home. Ripped apart and put back together. I thought, I hoped, I could find my family, cheat time, make us whole again. The way we were. But now I know. I know I can't go back. I know the world has changed. That the road ahead will be hard. This time, I'm ready. Because I know war. War never changes.
You've done an exemplary job here, Paladin. Without your unwavering loyalty to our cause, this victory would never have been possible. You truly have become one of us, brother. The Institute has been wiped clean from the face of our world. It's time we close this chapter on the Commonwealth and begin one anew. I'm pleased that you're anxious to continue your service for the Brotherhood. But this is neither the time nor the place to discuss it. Return to the Pridwin, and we'll decide what needs to be done. I'm too busy to speak right now.
You've done a heck of a job, Paladin. Ad Victoria.
I hope I live long enough to witness the Brotherhood's next triumph.
What is it?
This reminds me of my room back home. Yes, really.
Okay. What am I doing?
What's up? Oh, you shouldn't have.
Proctor Ingram has assured me that we'll be outside the blast radius. Press that button, and you not only defeat our enemy, you restore order and decency to the Commonwealth. It's time, Paladin. The Institute and their synth abominations must be eradicated. You've done an exemplary job here, Paladin. Without your unwavering loyalty to our cause, this victory would never have been possible. You truly have become one of us, brother. The Institute has been wiped clean from the face of our world. It's time we close this chapter on the Commonwealth and begin one anew. I'm pleased that you're anxious to continue your service for the Brotherhood. But this is neither the time nor the place to discuss it. Return to the Pridwin, and we'll decide what needs to be done.
You've done a heck of a job, Paladin. Ad Victorium.
I'm here. Trading? Sure, why not?
Well, look who's here. It's the newest Paladin. Congratulations on your promotion. No worries.
I hope I live long enough to witness the Brotherhood's next triumph.
You may have liberated.
Communications array calibration test successful. All bands nominal.
Paladin, I'm pleased you've returned. Captain Kells and I wanted to speak with you. Captain Kells.
As I expect, Elder Maxson has already explained. The destruction of the Institute is simply the first stage of our operations in the Commonwealth. There are still super mutants and ferals to be dealt with, as well as any remaining synths that escaped the blast. It's our hope that you will continue serving with the Brotherhood and assist us with eradicating these threats. Very good, Paladin.
In light of your service, Captain Kells and I both feel you deserve unique recognition for your contributions, both past and future. It's with great pleasure and the utmost respect that you are hereby granted the title of Sentinel. This is the highest honor a Brotherhood soldier can achieve, but we both felt strongly that it was well-deserved.
In addition, we'd like to present you with this jetpack modification for your power armor. The Brotherhood has few of these devices in its possession, but we feel you've earned the right to utilize one of them.
Congratulations, Sentinel. It's an honor to be serving with you.
In our division? Yes. There hasn't been a Sentinel serving under me for many years now. It's a position that commands a great deal of honor and respect, so I do not award it lightly. The honor is ours. So, Sentinel, for the first time since we've met, I have no orders for you. From this moment forward, you will decide which missions you undertake and how you will guide us. Captain Kells and the personnel at the Cambridge Police Station still possess numerous operations for you to undertake. Where you go from here is up to you. Ad victorium, Sentinel.
Stray radio signals keep pinging the array.
So the Brotherhood won. Are they going to set Liberty Prime loose in the Commonwealth? We could follow them around, killing raiders. I'd be up for that.
Here you go.
Hey, honey. Hello there, mister. Okay.
Superstructure integrity, green. Hull plating stable.
Selenite Alpha at 93%. Compensating.
Congratulations. They made you a Sentinel. You must have impressed the hell out of them. Got it.
What is it?
So, that's it. The Institute is destroyed. It's finally over.
You did issue the evacuation order, right? I didn't notice in all the chaos.
Good. I thought so. It was just watching that explosion. I just hope as many people as possible got out.
The way's now clear for the Commonwealth to finally come together and build something good for the future.
But it's not all sunshine and rainbows from here on out.
Couldn't have said it better myself, General. The Institute kept the Commonwealth divided for centuries. But there are plenty of other problems left to deal with. I don't think the Minutemen are going to be out of a job for a long time yet. As much as I might wish it.
Brothers and sisters, I will make this brief. I wish only to say thank you for all your hard work and dedication in the defeat of the Institute.
On the promotion to Sentinel.
Our sacrifices have been great.
You got what you wanted.
But thanks to all of
you,
we stand today in a Commonwealth free from the grip of madmen. Tomorrow always brings another battle.
Please tell me you're kidding. You can't be that blind. The fact of the matter is that innocent people died because Elder Maxon had delusions of grandeur. He kept preaching that the Institute was playing God for creating the synths. Well, you know what? Maybe he should take a look in the mirror, because he's the only one that I saw that's been playing God. Oh, God, now you're starting to sound like Maxon. He really got under your skin, didn't he? You know, I actually convinced myself that you were using Liberty Prime as leverage. That you were hoping for the Institute to surrender. This is the second time I've let the Brotherhood betray me, and I don't intend for there to be a third. I've already told Proctor Ingram that I'm through working on Liberty Prime. I'm going to work on my own projects in peace. So from now on, I suggest we stay out of each other's way. Ad Victorium, Sentinel.
You've done a heck of a job, Sentinel. Ad Victorium.
So, any other tricks up your sleeve besides making the Institute disappear? If I did, you'd be welcome to it. Heck, I'd give you a medal if we still use the darn things. You almost single-handedly finished everything that the Brotherhood came here to do. Even to a curmudgeon like me, that's pretty impressive. Anyway, I'm not here to talk your ear off. Maxon's informed me that you're continuing your tour aboard the Pridwin. So I was hoping you could assist me with a long-term problem. Keeping the Pridwin hovering like this is putting a tremendous strain on the ship's propulsion systems. I can stay ahead of the repairs, and we have plenty of fuel to keep the fusion reaction sustained, but we're short on reactor coolant. I'm not surprised. It isn't something the average soldier would be aware of. Here, take this list. It details exactly what you need to make a can of this special coolant. Find the materials, whip some of it up at any of the chemistry stations on the ship, and bring them to me. Pretty simple. If the coolant's good, then I'll even pay you for it, as per our retrieval compensation policy. Anyway, I guess that's it for now. Good luck.
I saw the Institute explode from up here.
I know I'm not the first to say this, but I appreciate what you did down there. The Institute got exactly what it deserved. This victory cost us a lot of lives, so you'll have to forgive me if I don't jump for joy.
There was this one pilot in particular. Rico was his name. I've been on this ship long enough that I watched him go from a greenhorn wastelander to a lancer. Every day, after his duty shift, he'd come back here and we'd talk about, well, everything. Sometimes for hours. I remember the day Kells put him in command of a vertibird. He ran right down here to me and handed me a bottle of whiskey. I told him to keep it, but he insisted. He said I was his friend. Felt he owed it to me for keeping him sane all those years. He was. Right before you got back to the Pridwin, Kells told me he was shot down. Some punk with a rocket launcher got lucky and blew him from the sky. I don't know why I'm telling you all of this. It's not really any of your concern. I guess I just wanted to show you that there's two sides to every victory. Those who live to revel in it, who died making it happen. Well, I think I've raked you through the mud for long enough. Here, I want to give you this as a token of my gratitude for everything you've done. I hope the gesture means the same to you as it did to me. Well, if it isn't our very own Sentinel. I got some special gear set aside for you. Let me know if you'd like to take a look. Be my guest.
May the Institute's fall be a lesson to anyone who'd risk tampering with our humanity.
That's quite the crater you've manifested in the center of Boston. Marvelous work. Simply marvelous. Nonsense. There's no need to be modest. You deserve all the accolades you've been receiving, and more. Your actions have proven to the people of the Commonwealth that the Brotherhood of Steel has their best interests in mind. That's quite an accomplishment for someone who was merely a new recruit only a short time ago. Well, I've already taken up more than enough of your valuable time. If you still wish to procure technical documents or escort one of my scribes, please let me know.
Feeling any after effects from the Institute explosion? I couldn't agree more. The Institute's destruction has certainly given the Commonwealth a brighter future. You did a hell of a job out there, you know? Everyone aboard is talking about it. Getting Prime built and then leading him right up to the Institute's front door like you did? It was damn heroic, if you ask me. Anyway, as long as you're feeling fine, you're cleared for active duty. Ad victorium, Sentinel.
You've done a heck of a job, Sentinel. Ad victorium.
The world is so much bigger than I've ever imagined.